So I am going to discuss right now how to measure the surgical blood loss. So there are five methods. One is visual observation. Second one is serial clinical estimation of the hemoglobin. Third is gravimetric method, which is the most commonly used method. Fourth is dilution methods. And fifth one is use of radioactive tracers method. Okay, so visual observation. Measurement of blood in surgical container, you can directly see it, or estimation in surgical sponges or laparotomy pads. Actually 4 into 4 centimeter laparotomy fully soaked gauze piece will accommodate 10 ml of blood, and soaked laparotomy pad is 100 to 150 ml. 1 ml of blood is equal to 1 gram of blood. Okay, directly you can measure in surgical container, or you can approximately by looking into the surgical pads. Second one is serial clinical estimation, which reflects the ratio of blood loss to the plasma. It does not reflect the amount of blood loss, which is correlated with clinical signs like hypotension, tachycardia, sweating, flushing. Okay, gravimetric method. This is the simplest and most commonly method. Preoperative weight of the swabs and towels are taken, and again after surgery and postoperative weight of the swab and towels are taken, and the difference is the gain of weight is equal to the amount of blood loss. And how will you? 1 ml equal to 1 gram, 1 ml equal to 1 gram of blood. What are the disadvantages? It underestimates the blood loss by 25%. It does not include evaporative loss and blood loss in floor drapes and body cavities. It can overestimate the blood loss if it measures pus, urine and other fluids in the mop. If mops contains other fluids like pus, urine and other body fluids, it can overestimate the blood loss. Okay, the fourth one is dilution methods or calorimetric method. Swab and towels are thoroughly mixed in a known volume of fluid and see the change in optical density of the water at isobastic absorption spectra of hemoglobin. In physiology lectures, you can see what is absorption spectra, what is isobastic point. Blood loss can be calculated by following formula: calorimetry reading multiplied by volume of the solution by 200 into patient hemoglobin percentage. Example, in TURP and ECMO. Disadvantages: incomplete extraction and contamination with bile. Fifth one is use of radioactive tracer techniques. Isotopes used are most pooled human albumin labeled with iodine 125. It is the most commonly preferred method, and RBC labeled with chromium 51. Repeated measurements are required to estimate the blood loss. So activity of the tracer is measured in first and injected IV. Activity of the remaining tracer in the syringe. You will take one syringe. You will take measure the activity of the tracer, and after injection, there will be some amount remain, and that activity is again measured. And the difference is calculated. After 10 to 15 minutes, sample is withdrawn from the other urn. From don't take sample in from the arm in which you have injected the radioactive pressure. Take it from the other arm and activity of the sample is measured. After that, dilution volume can be calculated from this result by comparing the different activity of the radioactive tracers. Okay, so these are the five methods. One is visual observation, what is serial clinical estimation of CBC, and gravimetric method, calorimetric method, and use of radioactive tracer methods. American College of Surgeons classes the acute hemorrhage into four stages. You should remember what are the four stages. These are quite these stages are hemodynamically unstable, hemodynamic stable phases, and you can read the factors like blood loss, kitna blood loss, pulse, BP, pulse pressure, capillary refill time, respiratory rate, urine output, and mental status. You have to remember this. This much you have to write when measurement of surgical blood loss is asked in exam. Thank you.